What's up guys, Tobias here and welcome back to another video of mine. As you can see by the video itself and the title, I've got another 87 rated squad for you guys. Last week I did make my own 87 rated squad thanks to the players Calfreeze sent me, and it did actually get over 270 likes. It just got under 300 likes and it did actually make it onto the top rated videos on YouTube that day, which is absolutely awesome. That's the first time that's ever happened to me. I've had my own videos on there, so that was pretty cool to be able to say I had a video on the top rated page of YouTube. And so yeah, you guys really did enjoy the video that I did make of that 87 rated squad, and I did get a lot of feedback. It did get over 7,000 views in the first 24 hours and it got an awful lot of comments. You guys extremely liked it, so I thank you ever so much for that. But a lot of people were following me on Twitter because of that video and linking me their squads, saying they had similar rated squads, and I did receive this squad you can see on your screen now. As you can see, it's a five star rated squad with a rating of 87, so it's exactly the same rating as the previous video. The only downfall I did emphasize in last video, which I did like about that squad in particular, was the fact it did have 100 chemistry. But unfortunately, as you can see here, we only have 97 chemistry in this squad. But nonetheless, out of all the squads I did receive, because I believe I was sent around three 87 rated squads. And so for anyone to have an 87 rated squad, they've either had to buy a lot of coins or open a lot of packs or be extremely lucky in packs, which involves buying the packs. So I guess they're the two reasons you would have an 87 rated squad. So I'm just going to go through this squad because, again, I do really like this. It's a shame it doesn't have 100 chemistry. Obviously, you guys put all in the comment section below, you changes you could make to the squad to improve it, to improve the chemistry. So you guys could leave comments for the guy whose squad this is, how he could improve this squad. But I'm just going to run through it. As you can see, it is using a 4-4-2 formation, which is one of the most expensive, if not the most expensive, formation on Ultimate Team, other than the 4-1-2-1-2, which I know is extremely expensive as well. The only thing I am going to say, the striker, which we can see, are Van Persie and Falcao. They do have cards on them, so when I do go through the stats of those two players, I will be reading the stats as they are without a card. So as you can see, he doesn't actually have 88 pace, he does have 78 pace. So when I do read their stats, that is what I'm reading it from. I've got them written down next to me. So I'm going to start in goal. We've got Buffon then, who's getting old, but he's still an absolute beast. The Italian number one striker, 87 rated Ultimate Team this year with 89 diving, 83 handling, and nearly 90 positioning. So he's 87 rated. He's an absolute beast. He's obviously in the Italian league and he is Italian. Moving on to the midfield, the defence, the two centre-backs we have then, we have Puyol and Hummels, the German centre-back and the Spaniard. Again, they are Puyol's 86 rated and Hummels is 85 rated. Looking at their stats, I'm just gonna leave them next to each other there. Both their defending stats are incredible. Puyol's got 87 defending and Hummels has got 85, and they both share the exact same heading of 84. In the left back then, we put the lowest rated player in this starting 11. We have Ashley Cole, who's 84 rated, arguably the best left back in the world. A lot of people have said he is the best left back. Personally, I don't think he is, but he is nonetheless a brilliant left back. Looking at his stats, they are shown it's 80 pace, which is fairly quick for a left back. Most of the time in defence, with the highest rated defenders, you will see that quite slow. For example, I'm just going to go straight back to Puyol here. He's got 55 pace. I do bang on about in my videos that the more the pace in a defender, the better, and that is, I will stand by that, because if you do get countered from a corner, for example, you do need a quick defender just to get back and help out of that counter attack and prevent the goal. And then finally in the defense, we have Lahm, again the second German in these four defenders, 87 rated right back from Bayern Munich, and again, looking at those stats, they are dirty as well. 82 passing, dribbling 82, defending 82, and pace 82, so he does like that 82 figure. So that is the four defenders and one goalkeeper. Moving on to the midfield then, I will start on the left hand side. We do have Iniesta, who's 80 rated overall left mid. Obviously, we could have had Ronaldo in here, for example. We could have got him in left mid and just stuck him in this squad. It would be exactly the same as Iniesta, as they are from the same league. Obviously, Iniesta is Spanish. He does play for Barcelona, so he does link in with the second midfielder, which I'll come on to in a minute. But he's got 290 rated stats, 91 passing and 91 dribbling. I have played with him, as you've seen from the squad I made last week. And his dribbling, when he gets the ball to his feet, there is no tackling him, really. You can just dribble past anyone, and he's an absolute beast, which is exactly the same as, which I can say for Xavi here. Center mid, 90, the exact same as Iniesta. He is slow, 66 pace, but that is made up by 93 passing and 87 dribbling. And so he's an absolute beast as well. I don't know how much these players were bought for. That's the only thing I'm not covering in this video, because otherwise it would be way too long. But 95,000 coins for a 90 rated centre mid in 4-4-2 formation is extremely cheap. So next to him then we've got Xabi Alonso, the 87 rated Spaniard centre mid from Real Madrid. Two Barcelona midfielders in this squad, and then the second two are from Real Madrid, as you can see here. 88 passing as well, which is an absolute beast when he gets the ball in the midfield. And then finally in the right mid position we have Di Maria, who's an absolute pace god. 80 pace, that's 90 pace, 82 passing and 87 dribbling. So the dribbling is the main stat in the midfield in this squad, obviously with an average midfield rating of, oh, I can't even work it out, it's probably around 87 88, because we do have two 90 midfielders in this squad. So he's an absolute beast as well. Even his shooting is 79, but in the game I haven't played too many games with Di Maria, in all honesty, but he doesn't feel like he's a 79 shooting player. He does feel like he's got a better shot on him than that, but he does have 87 dribbling, as I just said, as well as 90 pace. So that is the midfield for you. And then the two strikers we have in this squad, as I said at the beginning of this video, we do have Van Persie from Manchester United and Falcao, obviously, they are both 88 rated players. Those stats, even though they do have cards applied to them, that hasn't affected their overall rating of their players. They are both 88 rated. Both 88 rated, but I'm just going to run through those stats. As you can see, we have the pace and the shooting upgraded here. I believe there is nothing more. That dribbling has been affected, I believe. Yes, it has been. So in the actual game, if you have no cards in him, then he's got 78 pace, 89 shooting, 81 passing, 84 dribbling, 49 defending and heading of 68. So he has got quite a lot of cards on him. Don't know why he's not bumped up a rating. And then finally next to him, obviously, as I just said, we have Falcao, who, as well as him, does have some cards on him. He doesn't have a pace card, that is a pace as it is in the game, thankfully. He is extremely slow. I do have him in the main squad. I use an ultimate team, and that's the only thing I do dislike about Falcao. He's extremely slow when he does get on the ball. However, he does have 83 shooting, which 88 shooting, I believe. So that has got a card on him there. 57 passing, 78 dribbling, 53 defending, and 90 heading. That 90 heading hasn't been affected at all. His normal card, without any additional attribute cards on him, does have 90 heading, which you can absolutely take advantage of for the corners. To stick him in the box, you'll normally get a header on it and put it in the back of the net. So that is this week's 87 rated squad. I can't wait until someone sends me an 88 rated squad. I will be making a video on it. Unfortunately, I won't be able to make a video on it myself from the perspective of me actually having that squad, but as we can see, even his subs bench is an absolute god's bench. I would be thankful to have any of these. We've got Parlo here in the bench, 87 rated centre mid, and as you can see, the majority of them, if not all of them, I haven't even checked, they all do have Fabio Contrao. They all are in 4-4-2 formation as well, so you can just swap them. We've got Huntelaar here as well, 85 rated striker, and he's even on the bench. So I hope you did enjoy this video. If we could get over 250 likes again for this video and even get it onto the top rated, I will do something. I've already told you guys, if you follow me on Twitter, that I am going to be doing a challenge vlog. The challenge I've decided to do has not been decided yet, but I am going to do a vlog of a challenge. And if you do get this onto the top rated videos on YouTube again, then I will happily do two challenges, because I want to do a lot more video logs. Now my internet has finally been upgraded, so I've gone from my 5 meg download up to a 35 meg, and my upload has been increased dramatically as well. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Please do leave your comments in the comment section below about if there's anything you would change, someone you don't like in this squad. Obviously, the one thing I would change in this squad would be a left back. I'd try and bump up Ashley Cole and get a better player in the left back position. Obviously, as I said, it does have a 97 chemistry. That is because Hummels is affected with the chemistry I can see there. Obviously, Ashley Cole there and Van Persie, because neither of them have any links. But as I said, please do leave a like rating. It is greatly appreciated. If we could get over 250 likes, the same as the one I did last week, that would be absolutely awesome. And as I said, leave your thoughts and opinions in the comment section below. And until my next video, I'll be speaking to you guys later. Take care.